Hi, my name is Jay Wilburn, and we're at Bible Baptist Church, Erin, Tennessee. We're getting ready for Vocal Union, a cappella group out of Nashville, Tennessee. They originated in Paris, Tennessee. We're getting ready for the singing here in just a moment. We hope you enjoy it and hope you're blessed from it. God bless you. This is Jay Wilburn, WCBN Channel 12.
But speaking to yourself in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. Years ago, before there were any instruments, the old timers just sang. They didn't have there was a time they didn't have an organ. There was a time they didn't have a piano. There was a time they wouldn't even use a guitar. And so they just sang. And when you sing without music, it's called a cappella, and that's what these guys are about. And they make some wonderful music. And you're going to enjoy it. And the key is they're singing from their heart.
Amen.
Unto the Lord. And you listen close to the words of the songs. I promise you they'll minister to you. I was going to sing, have some congregational, but we're just going to let them get up here and take off with this thing. And we want you to pray. If you have a need tonight, this altar is open. And maybe you're hurting in some way. Maybe you're dealing with some temptation. Maybe there's something going on in your personal life. And you need to get along with God. This altar is always open. We're free here at Bible Baptist Church. You follow the Holy Spirit. Maybe you're here tonight and you're not saved. If that be the case, you need to get saved. We're living in the last days. We're living in some dark times. And you don't need to go another second unsaved. Jesus Christ died for your sins according to the Scriptures. He was buried and He rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. And if you will come to Him with a repentant heart and believe on Him and Him alone to save your soul, He'll save you and He'll wash your sins away. And so whatever your need might be during the psalm service, these altars are open and let God lead. So I'm going to lead us in prayer, and then I'm going to ask Vocal Union to come and let the Lord lead them. Heavenly Father, we thank You so much for these that have come out this evening. We thank You so much, dear God, for this place that You've given us to come and worship, where we can come and have scenes and events like this. And Lord, I pray that Your Holy Spirit presence will be real here in this place. God, I pray that You'd breathe on us from glory land. I pray, dear God, that You would just do something mighty and great. And Lord, we know that You're able to do that without a big crowd. Lord, there have been some times I've just been by myself, and You've done some mighty wonderful things for me, and I sure thank You for that. God, we know that there's a need in this place, and even though we're able to put on a facade, we're able, dear God, to put on an act and act like there's nothing wrong, nothing troubling us. But God, You know our hearts this evening. Amen. And You know what we need. God, as I try to preach Sunday night, dear God, I'm praying for that. I'm praying for that special anointing, that fresh oil, yes, dear God, that we all need, yes, as we live as Christians in this day and age that we live in. I pray that You fill us with Thy Holy Spirit. Amen. God, may we stay on our knees. May we stay in Your Word. God, may this evening, dear Lord, bring You honor and glory. Amen. And may we leave here, dear God, not just excited about Vocal Union, but may we all leave here tonight, including Vocal Union, may we all leave here excited about Jesus Christ. Yes. Lord, may we all leave here with strength and encouragement to go on and serve You a little more. And Lord, I thank You again in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 All right, from Nashville, Tennessee, originated in Paris, Tennessee, and I want you to make them welcome Vocal Union. While they're coming up here, we're also taping this, and I'm going to look back here at the camera. This is also going to be played on our local television station, WCBN Channel 12. And so let's give WCBN Channel 12 a show in front of the camera tonight. All right.
Discontentment. cast my every care upon the Lord.
Now let's see my reality, but it's Yeah.
say, get away.
Get away, joy.
I say, get away.
Get away, don't you,
Jordan. Get away.
Don't you leave, Jordan. I want to cross over and see my Lord.
Well, I promise the Lord, if you set me free,
well,
stage and sits in a vat of ice for quite some time, just to cool off a little bit. He really does. Hey, thanks a lot for being out here tonight, you guys. One of the things I can say is that you're looking at seven guys who just love to sing. And whether there was one of you here, or 50, I guess, as I said in class, 1010, that would be 110 in normal people's terms, but I've kind of mixed those up lately. Whether we have a huge crowd or small, I mean, it's just one of those things. We love to sing. And it's something that is just part of us. And one of the things I think is the greatest gifts that God has given is the fact that He gave people a voice.
Yeah, right.
And whether it's good or bad, it is a voice that was designed for a purpose of saying things and singing things that are pleasing to the Lord.
Right.
I love the fact that you have men up here that are all men, but very, very different kinds of voices, very different backgrounds, very different styles. They come together to sing about the same God.
Amen.
The God that loves us, loves you, loves me equally, because nobody is more even than at the foot of the cross.
That's right.
Let's be serious about that. Music is something that is designed for a purpose of praising the Lord.
Right.
It's heaven. This is a song called Heavenly Music.
Steals over the sea.
Yeah.
greatest news that man has ever heard. Then I came to a place where I trust, and I was given a choice. I could see Brother Taylor. Well, I could still hear his voice. If you want to follow Jesus,
answer his call.
Well, just answer his call.
sabbatical, is what they call it. We'll stick with sabbatical. A furlough, that's another good one too. We are your Rolodex. A source.
Roll the sun away, roll the sun away. The Lord God Almighty gonna roll the sun away. You promise you rise up.
Yeah.
Gateway's Christian. Yes. Amen. We got old King James Bible. We got the truth.
Yes. Yes. Stand on it.
Breathe. Yes. Yes. Shine that in America where the gays can stand up louder than the Christians.
Right. Yes. Amen.
That's good. Say, well, what about those Christian gays? Ain't no such thing.
That's right.
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 Amen. Right. They get saved. They get out of that stuff. Yes. Now I can come here and preach. Now this is my church. I preach for one.
Trusting Him and Him alone. Yeah.
Jesus, you are my only hope. Jesus, you are my salvation. Jesus, if I have any righteousness, I have it through you. I know I must have God's righteousness. And Jesus, for me to have it, I've got to have you. For you are God's righteousness. Amen. When you receive, I mean, when you receive me completely, that's salvation.
Amen.
That's salvation. Thank God for the unspeakable.
Praise God.
Hey, if I took you out to supper tonight, and I got up and went up to the cash register to pay for it, Brother Bob, you'd be off the city if you come through, and they said, Brother Bob, Pastor Wilbur's already paid for your meal. And you said, oh, no, I know he's paid for it, but I'm going to pay for it too. Wouldn't he be dumb to do such a thing? Hey, man. That'd just be a dumb thing.
Yeah.
Oh, I know it's paid for, but I'm not going to accept that. I'm going to pay my own way. And people are treating salvation that way. Right. Jesus has paid it all.
Right. Yeah.
All to him I owe.
That's right.
Sin had left its crimson stain.
Yeah.
He washed it
white. Yeah.
Quit trying to earn it.
Amen.
Quit trying to work for it.
Right.
And trust Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
You'll do that. You can walk away with peace in your heart.
That's right.
Amen.
I asked a fellow this one time, I said, if you were to stand before heaven right now, and they were to say, why should we let you in? What would your answer be? Let's all bow our heads right now real quick and think about that. I'm glad we can have service, we can have preaching, we can feel the presence of God without being away. So now, if you're just picture yourself now standing before the gate of heaven. And the Lord walks up and says, why should I let you into heaven? What's going to be your answer? Well, you need to let me into heaven because I've been a good neighbor. I've been a good child to my parents. I've been a good friend. I've tried to do some good deeds. I told my friend the other day I believed in God. You're letting me in heaven on that. If that's all you got, friend, you're not getting in.
Right.
Do you know if I was standing before heaven, the Lord would have said, Jay, why should I let you in? I say, Lord, the only way I can get in is through you, through the blood that was shed for me in Calvary.
Amen.
My only hope of coming, Lord, is I put my complete trust in your blood that was given at Calvary for my sins. I've not trusted in anything I can do because I know my righteousness is with your advent. Lord, I'm coming in simply because I received you as my Savior from my heart. And he's going to say, well, come on in.
Yes.
Any other answer? Lord, I should get in because I did this, or because I belong to this club, or because I belong to this organization, and I helped all. I did all this community service, and I did this, and I did that, and I did the other. No, listen, you're only going to get in by grace through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, if your answer was anything other than by grace through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, I mean, it had to be pretty close to that right there. You might be in trouble tonight. And we're going to sing again. They're going to sing again in a minute. If you're not saved, if you're not sure, that would be great. Thank you. I'm glad. Thank God for his unspeakable gift. Amen. The Bible says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God's eternal life.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. How can I be saved, preacher? The Bible tells you how to be saved. Thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in thy heart, God praise you. Thou shalt be saved.
Amen.
For with the heart man believes in the righteousness, with the mouth confession made salvation. I'm interested in somebody's soul, aren't you?
Amen.
I don't know, they're saved. All right, praise the Lord. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I pray that this message, this breath, dear God, would touch somebody's heart. Lord, I pray that something's been said tonight will help somebody. God, I pray that you'll leave here better, Lord, and not bitter. I pray that we'll leave here tonight, Lord, saved. Lord, if there's anybody here that's lost, they'll leave here saved.
Yes.
Not because they came to altar in a Baptist church. Not because they came and a Baptist preacher prayed with them. But because because they came to Jesus Christ and they trusted Jesus Christ. And Lord, I pray somebody be saved tonight. I pray somebody get some help tonight. Thank you again for loving us. Thank you for giving your life for us. Thank you for paying for our sins. Thank you for that unspeakable gift. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. All right, I'm going to have you guys come up and make some music before we take up an offering. Can y'all do that, Brother Gary? All right, let's see. Brother Bill. Let's see. I got three Brother Bills in here. Let's see who else can put there. Let's see, Brother George, you want to help take up an offering? You know, when you got a small crowd, you got to give a lot. Amen. I didn't get any amens on that, brethren. I'm worried.
Amen.
When you got a small crowd, you got to give a lot.
Yep.
Amen. Make up for them that ain't here. I'm going to dig out everything I got in my billfold. Amen. Amen. Go ahead and pray with offerings over here.
Dear Lord, we just appreciate this chance to be in your house tonight. We appreciate your guidance.
Where are you?
Yes.
Amen.
Someone has asked us if we could sing "It Is Well With My Soul."
Amen.
And I'd like for y'all to sing that with us. And if it's okay, I'd like for us to sing the third verse of that song. It's the verse that says, "My sin, oh the bliss, this glorious thought.
Right.
My sin, not in part, but the whole, was nailed to the cross. And I bear it no more." Could y'all stand with me and let's sing that verse together.
My sin, oh the bliss of this glorious thought. My sin.
Brother Jay was talking about was the comforter, the spirit that Jesus provided for us. And I've got the spirit within me. And I've got the joy down deep in my soul. I've got a feeling, a wonderful feeling. And I've got the Spirit, and He's taking control. I've got the Spirit, Spirit within me. And I've got the joy down deep in my soul, deep down inside me. I've got a feeling, ooh, a feeling, a wonderful feeling. Spirit, don't you know that He's taking control? Well, sometimes my heart's afraid, and sometimes I fall. Sometimes I lose my way. Sometimes I lose control. But each time You move my way, and each time I fall. Every time You're taking care of it all. I've got the Spirit, His Holy Spirit.
Spirit.
Yes, His Holy Spirit.
I've got the
got the joy.
Down deep in my soul.
Way deep in my soul.
I've got a feeling,
yeah.
A wonderful feeling.
So wonderful feeling.
Well, I got the Spirit.
His Holy Spirit.
He's taking control.
Oh, stepping on a cloud, stepping on a cloud.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, hey, I want to take a chance here real quick to introduce you to the next guy you're going to hear from. You've been hearing from him all night, and maybe your ears don't register these low notes, like something like the human ear only registers between a certain range. And often, Gary Miller is under that range. So if you listen right now, he's singing right now. It's just, it's so low, you know what I mean? He's going to be singing the next song. There really is, I think it's a very personal song for me. I'm 29 years old. I'm a pup in this world, if you will. And last week, I sang in a church that was built in 1852. And I'm a U.S. history high school teacher. And so I was looking at, I was just like sitting in this building in these walls, and really there had been some stuff added on, but there are these four original walls. And I was thinking, what has happened in this building, man? Like, the stories that have happened in these walls are mind-boggling.
Yeah.
These walls have been up for about a year now, yeah. And the God that they were worshiping in 1852 is the same God that they've been worshiping.
Amen.
I gotta tell you, and just kind of personally with this, I teach high school history, and the reason I got into teaching high school, to me it's a ministry position, it really is. I love teenagers. I was saved as a teenager. I'll share a little bit more about that in a little bit, but I go into my classroom every day at 7:30, which is way too early for adults, let alone teenagers. And I look out and I see these faces that just scream, "Make me laugh, clown." And I have to look at them and be as energetic as possible, have to be as purposeful as possible. But it's all with one purpose. And that's to be Jesus in their life. Not to be Jesus, but to be that person that they can look at and think like, this guy's living it out, man. It might not be as bad as everybody says it is.
Right.
Those who don't get it might think that. It's a passion for me to get to speak to people and speak to teenagers and tell them about a little story. I'm a history teacher. I tell a lot of stories. But Pastor Jay spoke of one that said, a lot of times people say, once upon a time, this and this. And shoot, maybe I even said a lot concerning real factual stuff that happened in history. But the true story is whatever happened in 1852, whatever happened in 2008, whatever's happened since the creation of the world, it's all revolved around one story. And I don't even say this as a response. I say this because this is something that changes your life.
Amen.
When you realize what happened on behalf of you and for you.
Amen.
This is a song called Once Upon a Tree.
Yes. Amen.
Once upon a tree,
suffered loss, and the cost, greatest stories.
He gave his life for you.
Actually sitting right there, hiding behind the young lady in the second row. Put your hand up, Papa. This guy right here, this guy's name is Wayne Allen. I haven't even given him his birthday present yet. I'm waiting until 11:59 p.m. tonight to make the let the curiosity stew a little bit. For the last probably 5 years, all he's asked for every Christmas, Father's Day, and birthday has been a Home Depot gift card, which I did not get him for his birthday, and there could be some scandal involved there. I did give him a gift receipt for what I did give him. But in 1998, 11 years ago, El Nino swept through the country, and he affectionately nicknamed himself El Nino in the wake of El Nino. So we got a little song for him right now. Here we go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, El Wayno. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday. My dad's birthday. This is something very significant about that day and about that this day is my father, my parents. We celebrated Mother's Day last week, and this is the first day of time I've seen my mother, actually, since last Sunday. Not last Sunday. Didn't even get to see her on Mother's Day. My parents mean an incredible, incredible thing to me. It is because of my father, and I don't even know if I've even said this publicly out loud to him. It is because of my father that I am a Christian. In 1994, when I was a freshman in high school, I was August 21st, 1994, just about ready to start my day, my freshman year, and I was spending the night at a friend's house, and my sister comes to the door, and my sister says, "We have to go." And I said, "What's going on?" It's about 9 o'clock, and she said, "Your dad's been in an accident." "Your dad, our dad." She said, "Dad's been in an accident." I said, "Is he all right?" And she said, "We have to go to the hospital." And so as we're walking out, I'm trying to get these answers from her, and I don't even know if she knows really anything. But we get to the hospital, and my dad was lying in a stretcher with his neck supported, and he'd been in a car wreck and broke his neck. And the doctors had told my mother that he probably wasn't going to live through the night. And that was probably the first time, I'll say it was the first time, that I prayed for real. Something that wasn't just, "God is great, God is good, now I thank you for this food." I said, "God, if you save my dad, I promise I'll start going to church." And that's what it meant to me at the time. I was 14 years old. And my dad is sitting right there.
Amen.
And I love him tremendously for God using him to save me and saved him at the same time.
Amen.
My dad was baptized at 55 years old on the marriage retreat that invited me and my wife to with him. And one of the things I think that has touched me so much about getting to be a part of this right here, getting to be a part of my family, has been the fact that we didn't really grow up going to church. And so our lives, when God says that I will change your family tree, at 14 I was saved. And since then I have seen my sisters, both of my sisters come to the Lord. I've seen my mother, I've seen my father come to the Lord. And the Allen name is changed because of that.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
One of the things that I think is just so special about that is that the worship that we sing when we're up here, and this is true of every single one of these gentlemen up here, I know them personally, that this worship comes absolutely not as a measure of what we do just because we like to sing, but it's something that is an extension of our hearts. It's an extension of our relationship with Jesus Christ. And I'm telling you right now that I stand here as a guy who is absolutely worth nothing except the fact that Christ looks at me and says, Michael, I love you.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
It's
a song called We've Gotta Sing.
We've got to sing with our hearts, make a melody, teaching others with the song that we sing. We've got to sing, sing with our hearts, make a melody. Praise the Lord and teach His word. Now we all want our songs to sound good. We want each voice to sing the note that it should, but we must also sing it with our hearts. It doesn't matter if you can't sing the right part. We've got to sing with our hearts, make a melody, teaching others with the song that we sing. We've got to sing, sing with our hearts, make a melody. Now you might say that your voice is bad, you ain't got the voice that you once had. But God commands His children to sing, so lift your voice to heaven and let it ring. Oh, we got to sing with our hearts, sing with our hearts, make a melody, teach with the song that we sing. Sing with our hearts, make a melody. Praise the Lord and teach His word.
Sub-bass, Gary Miller.
Thank you. We enjoy being here tonight. We know that we are saying
He submitted like a gentle lamb and let them kneel him there and pray. Forgive them, for they know not what they do. Oh, there never was a pulpit like the old rug and cross, and there never was such a meeting place as Calvary. There never was a greater lesson preached on love by mortal man, and there never was a suffering. Jesus saw some good in him, and he forgave that man, and said, "Today into my heaven enter in."
is at the old ship of Zion I see its hope.
Well, in my robe of
These fellows and the gift of song you've given to them. We praise you.